have their own areas, but it's totally independent from the city and the state and the government apparatus in general. So they were targeted and they were attacked in August of 1978. And then again in May 13th, 1985, a bomb was dropped on their home, which ended up destroying an entire block in Philadelphia. And Mumia Abdul-Jamal was one of the only journalists that would report on what was happening with the MOVE organization in any kind of objective way. Every other media outlet in Philadelphia was part and parcel with whatever the state and whatever the mayor and whatever the police line was, they were parrot that. And Mumia, again, the voice of the voiceless. This is a critical voice. Even when he was free, and even when he was locked up, he continues to speak about what's going on with the MOVE 9. And I believe one of the MOVE 9 members just had a parole hearing that was denied a couple days ago. Two of the MOVE 9 have since died. One of them has died in custody. Another one died under mysterious circumstances. So we know the situation with the MOVE 9 is critical, so please stay involved with that. They're coming up on the 39th anniversary of the MOVE attack in August of 78. So there's going to be some actions in Philadelphia around that as well. Another political prisoner I just want to speak about, two others I just want to speak about real quickly, are Imam Jamil Al-Amin, formerly H-Rap Brown. And he's been in a very similar situation as Mumia, because both of them have been facing what we call state execution by medical neglect. Again, state execution by medical neglect. Now, that's happening to a lot of prisoners in general, particularly the political ones. So same deal with the Mumia with the Hep C. That happened to Imam Jamil, former H-Rap Brown, where he was basically had a melanoma, a form of cancer as well, and was unable to get the proper health treatment. We ended up doing a few campaigns to get him moved to a situation where he could actually get some more health, basically being seen by doctors and stuff. And so that's happened, but we still say free Imam Jamil, free them all. You can check out www.imamjamilactionnetwork.org, imamjamilactionnetwork.org, to find out more about what's happening with the rap. We say free the rap, free them all. Last situation I want to speak on also is Dr. Mutulu Shakur. Dr. Mutulu Shakur, we say free Dr. Mutulu Shakur, free them all. Anyone that hears my voice right now, if y'all know who Tupac Shakur is, you should know who Dr. Mutulu Shakur is. And I will say, that's one thing I was impressed with, this new Tupac film, Hollywood movie that came out, All Eyes on Me, because they actually showed Dr. Mutulu in there. And they showed a sister of Phoenix Shakur in there as well, and referenced Asada Shakur, who was Tupac's auntie as well, you know what I mean? But Dr. Mutulu Shakur is another situation where he's been in prison for almost 30 years and was due to be released, but the state is stopping his release. So we say free the doc, free Dr. Mutulu Shakur, free all political prisoners, free Mumia Abdul-Jamal. These cases are all very connected, and it's all about how the state views those who revolt against it, those who have any kind of dissension, those who have any kind of resistance. You immediately are targeted, and they benefit off of them being isolated and not being connected. But the fact that we can gather here today, even if it's just 50 of us, this shows a strength, because they cannot just execute and do whatever to our brothers and sisters. 2 million locked down right now behind enemy lines in these concentration camps. Let's keep it real. This ain't no prison industrial complex. That's a euphemism. These are concentration camps. What's going on in these hells is worse than anything we could possibly imagine. So what's the call? Free them all. All right, so next up I want to bring up a comrade of mine, a humble servant of the people. This sister is always there, no matter where she needs to be. She's gonna be there, never really looking for that credit, but always just doing the work that how it has to happen. So I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for her calling me out. So I appreciate her. Revolution, love, and solidarity. Sister Tova from the Workers' World. Sister Tova, make some noise, y'all. Free Mumia.